In this tutorial, we will see how to create helix and how to use it to create a spring. So helix command you can give from here draw panel, select helix. So before that we will just switch to southeast isometric so that we can view the helix. We will make it UCS icon, no origin. Then we will say draw helix. Then he is asking for center point of base, so wherever you want it you can click it. Then he is asking me asking for specify base radius, so you can give the radius whatever you want. Suppose I want 4. Then he is asking top radius. Suppose if you want to create a taper helix, you can give lesser radius. Suppose I give it 3, I want a taper helix. Then give the height, how much height you want it. Suppose I want the height of 8. So in this way it has created a taper helix where bottom radius is 4 and top radius is 3. By double clicking this you can fine tune the helix. Just double click, so it will show the property panel. From here you can fine tune it. So constraint you can define, turn height or turns or height, what you want to constrain to. Suppose I want to constrain to height. Then he is asking the height, what is the height. So height is 10 suppose. Then number of turns, how many turns you want. Suppose I want turns to be 6, so turns have been increased. Then turn height, individual turn height you can define, which can be called as a pitch also. So suppose turn height I will keep 1.5. Then he is asking top base radius and top radius. So here we have given less top radius because we want a taper spring. If you want cylindrical spring, then you have to use same radius at base radius and top radius. So it will create a cylindrical spring. Then you can define the twist. So you can say it either clockwise or counterclockwise. So now it is counterclockwise. So if I say clockwise, it will be clockwise in this direction. So in this way you can control create a spring. So to come out, just press the escape. To convert this spring into convert this helix into a spring, you have to create a cross section. Suppose I want a circular spring, so I will just draw a circle of desired radius. Then to convert this helix into a spring, you have to use sweep command. So go to sweep. Then he is asking for select object to sweep, so I want to sweep this circle. Then press enter, then select sweep path, so I want to sweep on this path. Just click on the path, so it will create a spring. So you can view the spring in conceptual visual style. So in this way using sweep command, this spring has been created. Or if suppose you want a square cross section as a square, then you can create a square first here. Suppose using rectangle command, I will create a square or rectangular cross section you can define. Suppose this is the cross section. Suppose I want this is my cross section, square cross section. So again I will say sweep, then select the cross section, enter, then click on the sweep path. So it will create a spring of square cross section. So in this way you can define the desired cross section for the spring, and as per that the spring will be created. Same way you can also use this for creating the threads also. Suppose some cylindrical part is there, I will just create a circular part. Suppose a circular part of 5 radius, and I will press pull it to give the height. Suppose I give the height of 25, and I want to create a thread on it. So I will just create a helix of radius 5. So just create a helix. So I will create at the center of this rod. Bottom radius is 5, top radius is 5. Then height I will define as suppose 15. So this helix is created there. So you can fine tune the helix by double clicking on it. Just click on it. Okay, to make the selection simple, I will switch to 2D wireframe. Just click on the helix. So from here you can fine tune it. So I will define number of turns to be suppose 15. Turn height is 5. Suppose I want a pitch of 3. So I will set turn height of 3. Then number of turns, then he's asking turn height 3, then base radius, okay. Number of turns, suppose I want it to be of 5 number of turns. Then turn height has become 1.5. So suppose I want a square thread, so I will create a square of 0.75 by 0.75. So here I will say first point, right click, dimension 0.75 by 0.75. So this square is ready. Then I will just give the direction where you want the square. Then I will say sweep. Then I will select this rectangle, enter, then right click. So I want to sweep using a base point. Suppose this point should be, one base point should be used. Then I will click on the helix. So this helix has been created here. So we can view that in conceptual visual style. So in this way it has been created. So I want to create a thread, so I will subtract it. So for that I will say subtract, then I will select the rod, then enter, then this sweep object, enter. So in this way you can create a square thread or desired thread. So in this way you can use sweep for creating threads also. So that's all. Thanks for joining. We'll stop here.